And for that, we have to prepare. Even the preparation is for easy things. You know, like these brothers, they had a wedding yesterday. They prepared for the wedding. You go on a holiday, you prepare for your holidays, don't you? There's a preparation for everything. You go on a holiday, you start preparing. People prepare weeks before they travel somewhere. In the same way, brothers and sisters of Islam, this month is a blessing. This is one of the greatest of those breezes of mercy that are mentioned in the light of the hadith of the Prophet that we are all blessed with. If we are alive till the month of Ramadan, we have to prepare for it. And the preparation begins in the month of Shaaban al-Muazzam. And this is why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, according to one hadith, he used to be so excited about Ramadan that in the month of Shaaban, first the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to fast most days of Shaaban. And according to one narration, the most song of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, most fasting of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam out of Ramadan was in Shaaban. And he used to tighten the loincloth as if the time of hard work has come now. He used to tighten his loincloth, prepared for Ramadan. Yes, Ramadan has come. This is the time for hard work. That should be our niyyah. Let us make this niyyah, brothers and sisters in Islam. After Ramadan, we will be exhausted. We will be tired as if on the Eid day. After Ramadan, we will say to ourselves, yes, I truly deserve this Eid. I earned this Eid. Eid is for me. Why? Because I'm tired throughout the month of Ramadan. We will spend time reciting the Quran. We will spend time in the ibadah of Allah Jalla Wa'ala. We will recite Nawafil. We will have a one-to-one communication with Allah Jalla Wa'ala in the form of du'as. We will talk to Allah Jalla Wa'ala. We will communicate with Allah Jalla Wa'ala. And we will make ourselves so tired and so exhausted after Ramadan. And on the day of Eid, we will feel that I deserve this Eid. That's preparation for Ramadan. You see, can you make a comparison between the attitude of those who say, Ramadan has come, it's difficult. Long hours, fasting isn't. Why? Yuridullah bikum al-yusra, wala yuridu bikum al-usra. Allah wants ease for you, He doesn't want difficult for you. Difficulty for you. Ease for who? The one who's after taqwa. The one who enjoys the hunger. The one who enjoys the thirst. He enjoys it. Why? Because in the month of Ramadan, he thinks about the thirst of mahshar, the hunger of the day of judgment. That's why he thinks about it. That's why he enjoys it. He loves it because he knows that with this test he will be blessed with the vision of Allah Jalla Wa'ala. This is Bab Rayyan, the door of Rayyan. Why does Allah say Rayyan is for the people who fast? The special door for the fasting people who will enter Jannah. Allah says fasting is for me and I will reward you for it. And the special reward for a fasting person is seeing Allah Jalla Wa'ala. And the concept of taqwa is seeing Allah. Because what did the Prophet ﷺ say about ihsan? كَأَنَّكَ تَرَاهُ As if you are seeing Allah. And if you can't see Allah, then Allah is seeing you. Allah is watching you. That's what taqwa is all about. Allah is watching you. And a fasting person, when his throat is screaming, oh, give me some water. Give me some food. I'm hungry. He's alone. No one else is watching him. Who is watching him? That shows that he has reached that maqam. He doesn't see Allah, but he believes Allah is seeing him. Allah is watching him. That's a fasting person. You see, the heart of a human beats all the limbs and organs of the body. Yes? Why is it? We listen to what the throat says. We don't listen to what the throat says. The throat says, give me some water. I'm thirsty. There's no one else watching you. No one else can see you. The stomach says, give me some food. But the heart says, I'm the leader. I will lead you. I'm in command. I'm in control. I will not have you let you have any water, any food. But the same way, the way we do not listen to the throat and the stomach, in the same way, we will not listen to our eyes. We will not listen to our ears. We will not listen to our tongue. When our tongue wants to say something which is haram, we will say no. The heart is still in command. In the same way, after the month of Ramadan, the heart will not obey the commands of the eyes. When the eyes will say, go and watch haram. The ears will say, go and listen to haram. The hands will say, go and touch haram. The feet will say, go to places of haram. The heart will say, I'm still in command. Why? Because now the heart has a building around it. The heart has a shield around it. The heart is protected. You build it yourself in the month of Ramadan. Now no one can attack the heart. The heart is in command. The heart is the leader. The heart doesn't obey the commands of the hands and the feet and the tongue and the eyes. Why? Because the heart did not obey the command of the throat and the stomach. But for that, the training within us.